You do realize I set it up so party audio was not included for that reason.
It used to be a military base. Well, it used to be a ranching thing, then it was turned into an army thing, then it became a bird thing and a museum or whatever. Henry Fonda stationed here, I think, for a bit. Unless he was Navy. Who's Henry Fonda? Around Christmas time, this little breakfast place used to sell these amazing polar bear sugar cookies. Man, those were good. And then one year they changed the formula or whatever and ruined it.
Okay.
Alex? Hey, still with us? You haven't said anything
I
for like.
can watch the hypnotic rolling of the waves and listen to you at the same time.
Oh, okay. What did I say? Little miss, I can see and hear things at the same time.
Something, something, cookies, or whatever.
Perfect. You're right on the money. So you all moved in?
PM.
Not really. I just got in this morning.
And how did her mom meet your dad exactly?
They met on vacation in Orlando. He got lost in a, you know, actually, I'm not.
Hey, there's an old ship's wheel up here. It's a replica from a Portuguese caravel, it says.
Yeah, I think the Portuguese discovered the island. I don't know. I mostly slept through the maritime portion of history class. Wait, were you.
Who's driving this?
That's Sea Captain Karen. She's doing us a favor. You'll notice we're the only ones doing the voyage. How you doing up there, Karen?
Yeah, I didn't notice that.
It's a little hush-hush, but she's dropping us off and then doing a, miscount on the way back, so we can spend the night. And you guys just met tonight?
Yeah, I'd been out of school, and the timing had just never worked out, so.
And what does that make you to her then? A second cousin?
He's my stepbrother.
Oh, yeah. I forgot that was even a thing. Well, at least you seem cool, right? Cool guy, cool hat. You get a cool new sibling living right in your house. Sharing your toothbrush. Wearing your clothes. Eating your food.
No, that's the weird part. I mean, isn't it like. The concept of just getting a new sister like a puppy, isn't it kind of awkward?
No, it's been totally bizarre. But just for the record, I don't consider you a pet. So, how do you two know each other?
Oh, from way back when, like Paleozoic. Grade school era. Young enough that I've seen her in a bathtub and it wasn't sexual at all. I mean, we both looked like little skinned potato balls.
Stop.
Ren, why are you even talking about this?
It's humorous, right? It's just interesting. I think it's interesting. Check under your seat to make sure you don't leave behind any grandchildren.
So how do
It's
you
a
know?
recording. They always play. Oh, we should get a quick picture. All of us. This will be like the
Yeah,
before.
let's do it.
And it's Jonas, not Jonah.
Yeah, Jonas. Like Jonas Salk?
Right, patient zero, AIDS guy.
Jonas. It means oppressor, right?
Yeah, but I mean, my sign's Cancer, and it's not like my hair's falling out or anything. Here's good. Come on, Alex, join the fun. We need the girl in the picture, Alex, to balance some of this out. Alex, we're not taking. There, great. I'll magic erase all the warts out and stuff, so don't worry. Hey, Alex, you brought the radio, right? The little portable one?
Yeah, of course.
Perfect. Can you pull it out a second? There's the little guy. Our high school has a radio station, and Carly, she's a friend of ours. She's filling in because Reggie got mono from some track runner or something. It doesn't matter. What matters is that she's gonna say something like, basically, right now, about our thing. So, tune it to 88.3 so I can tell her we heard it.
Which I played because that song's been stuck in my head since I woke up this morning. But, oh, actually, it's a little after 10 o'clock, which means my dear friend Ren and his buddies are probably just touching down on Edwards Island for the yearly bash on the beach or whatever we call it now. But anyways, I promised him that I'd play a song from his band, so hope you're listening, Ren. Here are the Red-Headed Bedwetters with Baby Carrots.
That's awesome. I hope Christina, with her talent show judge face, was listening. must be getting close. There's no radio reception on the island. I'm glad I got to hear it before it went totally kaput.
If we can't use it, why'd you bring it? Not just for the boat.
No. You'll see. I don't expect too much, but nah, it'll be fun. I won't undercook it. You'll see.
Do not trust. So that is not CJ watching. Hey, hello, random watcher.
Smell that clean air, boys and girls. Boy and girl. This ain't city living.
Yeah, anybody need a smoke? I have a full pack.
No thanks. I mean, I literally just said the emo thing, so...
Alex, you can bum one off me if you're empty. I forget if you're a fellow addict.
No thanks. I don't smoke. The last time I had one, it didn't go well.
Yeah, no, I didn't know what coughing with your whole body meant until I saw you dry heaving.
Okay, just checking.
All right, my other friend should be up and around the bend.
Actually, that... I mean, I don't mean to be the guy to break us up already, but Ren, can you do me a favor? Can I have, like, 2 real quick minutes with Alex for a second? And you can, you know, you can run up and meet your friends?
Really?
Wait, is something wrong? What is it?
Nothing's wrong, nothing's wrong. It'll just take 2 minutes, super fast.
All right, but, look, I don't want to go up by myself. I mean, can't we just stick together? You're gonna have all night to say, like, whatever.
But since you want to meet up with your friends anyway...
It's fine, Ren. Go on up ahead and we'll catch up with you.
Okay. I guess. Though this is a really strange way to start off, splitting up.
It'll be fast. Thanks, man.
I'll just be up the hill, in case... whatever.
Ren seems nice. He's funny, you know? Reminds me of a guy I know back home.
Yeah, I mean, he's harmless. But, yeah, he's nice.
Listen. I just wanted to grab you ahead of time and say you've been cool about everything. And I guess it's just for me, I've never moved anywhere. And, like, getting a new family at the same time kind of feels like I'm skipping the training wheels. Not that it's been bad or anything. You and your mom have been great.
Well, how do you think I feel? My house just shrunk by half because my mom decided to get some in Florida.
No, I know. I'm sorry. Oh, and thanks for setting up the attic for me. It's cool how it's like a little bedroom.
Yeah, no problem. Anytime. It's nice at night, isn't it?
Yeah. We can catch back up with Ren now. I didn't mean to take so long.
It's kinda kitschy. Right? It's kind of kitschy?
Yeah, it's like a quiche.
I think they'd block this off at night since nobody needs to use it. Or maybe they just had a parade?
Sure, either one.
Ah, I forgot this was even here. It's a monument to some submarine that was sunk off the coast.
Oh, do the radio guide thing they talked about on the boat, you know? It's what, like 102.3?
Okay, sure.
I think they said it's...
Named after the Hawaiian god of the sea, the USS Kanaloa was launched on January 15th, 1941, and commissioned into service at the end of that year.
I've never heard of this before. Kind of creepy in a way. Right?
On October 28th, 1943.
Yeah, my dad had a bunch of comics named that from like the 70s, but it was like literally Marines fighting Satan or dinosaurs or something.
Submarine casualty in a... Named after the Hawaiian god of the sea, the USS Kanaloa was.
Parks and Facilities Office. Ren's sister Allison used to work there. You'd like her, she's tall.
All right.
Man, they close up early.
Guess no point in staying open if nobody's here.
Hello,
oh,
kids.
We're here.
No,
maybe
the other guys and girls
ornament
must be further up, so be quick now. Okay, speed read definition of Edwards Island. This is a tourist trap with shops and a beach. Nobody lives here except for some geriatric named Mrs. Adler. But, as God is my witness, I'll never mention her or any other old person's name again. We are here to drink and be stupid. A tradition apparently started by bored recruits in the 1950s who would sneak dates over from the coastal towns. They literally called it trawling.
Uh-huh.
Wait, how'd they pull that? Isn't, like, security an important thing in military bases?
Yes, but apparently the desire to have cheap sex. The beaten path officially ends here. The beach is past the fence. I think Jerry told me that... That there's a way that you used to get over there, but I'm blanking on what it was. But it's not... I mean, it can't be too difficult. So...
I think the dumpster will get us over if it'll... budge.
Well, let's try it.
Anyways, the town's youths keep the whole slink over and camp thing alive and well.
No, I got it.
Improper acts? What does that even mean? Soaping windows?
Yeah, I don't think that'll get us lost in the stockade.
No. But maybe the fact that I brought a whole crap ton of drugs will.
Oh, well, yeah, that'll do it then.
Of course you did.
I've been looking forward to this for a really long time, and I'm not leaving the fun part of this to chance. That's all. And the other thing is the weirdo caves.
Weirdo caves?
The whole reason Alex brought her radio is because when you go to the... It's like the front.
The mouth?
The mouth of this particular cave, you can sometimes pick up frequencies to stations that don't exist. You'll hear voices.
Yeah.
Before we get there, I should probably mention that.
Oh god.
Who's that?
That's so there's this girl, Nona. She's just this girl, and I'm totally into her, and I want her to be into me. So just, you know, just be cool, okay? No pouting or complaining or anything, all right? Deal?
Ren, relax.
Oh, and okay, Jonas. Now that we're dumpster buddies, what was the thing that you said to Alex back then?
Emo, I'll send that to you later.
Digital tales or something?
It was nothing, really.
Just leave it alone, Ren, alright? You don't have to hear everything.
I don't have to hear everything, but I want to hear everything.
It's not a big deal, really. Just forget about it.
Reginald, I hear you over there.
Hey, guys.
Wait, I was about to tell a story. What was it?
About Brad's car?
Oh, well...
Hey.
We started a fire down the way, but Nona wanted to play beach nanny, so...
Yeah. Everyone, this is Jonas. Jonas? Everyone.
Hey.
Hi.
And Jonas, that's...
Who are you again?
Jonas.
He's Alex's new in town, fresh as the daisy, stepbrother.
Stepbrother?
Really?
Yeah, I know. It's a trip.
Yeah, he's a cool guy from cool North Valley, so let's all try and show him a good time.
Just the beach and some beer will be enough, I'm sure.
Wait. You're Jonas. Jonas, the stepbrother.
Yeah. What's your name again?
That is Clarissa,
How
but
are
she's...
your stepbrother? Like, what does that even mean?
My mom married his dad, so family law and all.
Yeah, well, I guess this is happening now. This is a thing that is happening, so... Where's everyone else?
Nicole had that tennis thing.
And?
Who else was supposed to come?
Anyone? Everyone?
Clarissa, we took the last ferry. I thought more would show up, but...
Oh my god, it's just Alex and her new stepbrother? Huh, that's it. That's who you brought. That's the group.
Clarissa, seriously, who even invited you?
I did.
Ren invited Nona, and Nona invited me. Though, beg me would maybe be the better way to put it.
I didn't. I didn't really beg.
Wait, aren't you all, like, friends?
I'm friends with Nona, and I'm downgrading Ren to, like, a creepy neighbor. And you, I just met.
Yeah.
Well, sorry.
I accept your apology.
What did I do?
You see, Jonas, normally this is like a 20-deep rager, but Pat had a party last weekend, and...
And a bunch of kids got caught TPing the school.
But this is great, right? We're on Edward's Island. Forget those losers who couldn't handle the weekend, who didn't think we could make it, who lost my invitation, who had to go
faster.
On their... We've been hearing about this for years, and now we're gonna do it. This is gonna be amazing, right? Right, guys?
Yay! Awesomeness!
Yeah!
Do 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 do.